Richard Olsen, founder of Lykke. Welcome to our first session on the impact of the coronavirus and how to respond in this economic environment with measures to reverse and mitigate the impact on the economy. I want to briefly discuss the coronavirus itself, then focus in on the economic impact, highlight the technology and decentralization technology as a method, as a remedy, explain what Lykke can contribute, and finally, end with a brief statement about the regulatory strategy. So coronavirus is really a very infectious flu, which so far has infected 100,000 people with slightly more than 2 months. China has opted for very draconian measures, and in the meantime, it's starting to spread around the globe. The biggest challenge of coronavirus is actually its impact on the healthcare resources, and the threat is that if too many people become ill too rapidly, the healthcare resources cannot cope. It's obviously unknown how the virus would really spread. Fast, slow, very fast, we don't know, but it is spreading too fast for safety. But we don't know also how the governments respond. Will they be very proactive or actually be slow? Finally, what we don't know today is the economic impact of the coronavirus. What is sure is that people stay home and the amount of spending will be dramatically reduced, which affects all businesses. We have seen the impact on an economic level already by trade with China dropping dramatically. In the previous week, we have seen a dramatic drop in the stock markets, like close to 20%. We today don't know for sure how big the impact is on the economy. Scenarios differ. Some people say it's just a significant slowdown. Others believe it's a massive hit for the global economy. Central bankers have already embarked on what they have done since 2008, that is, rate cuts and quantitative easing. Their strategy has been, and so far continues to be, to provide cheap funding for banks in the hope that the banks will then hand out and pass on the money to the rest of the economy. We have witnessed that this has worked to boost the economy, but has really not had that impact which we had hoped, in the sense of strengthening the underlying economy. Now it's clear the coronavirus will have an impact, potentially much bigger than just a minor kind of recession. So what can we do? I argue, my colleagues argue, that technology can help. Technology, why is that so interesting? Because technology can help bottom up. It's something which is not top down, but anyone who starts to deploy it can leverage its full potential. The genius of blockchain, this is the technology we propose to deploy, is that it dramatically simplifies everything that historically has been done by middle and back offices and banks. And the technology can be used for any type of industry that wants to use financing as its core feature. Key is that with this technology, it's possible to tokenize any financial asset, and now this can be done at a fraction of the cost. The token itself will represent the financial product. It's like a share certificate. So key of tokenization is that we can tokenize all assets from property, natural resources, and most important, shares of small, medium, and also big enterprise. But also governments can use it. They can tokenize their services which they provide and all the assets which are at disposal of governments. So key of that technology is that it can unlock the resources of that are available to the masses, to the man in the street, everyone. And most important, this is not just a statement of let's do something, but it's really an empowerment of the people in the street and will therefore be inspirational. Lykke has been working on this technology for many years. Our vision is to create a seamless liquid global marketplace that allows for easy issuance of shares and utility tokens and includes wallets which are in your smartphone. And now, when you go and use your smartphone and go into the shop, everyone, every person can choose with what tokens he wants to use to buy. And the most important is that the recipient, the shop owner, will receive the token that he wants to receive, that everyone is paid in the currency and token of his choice. In the background, there is a fluid exchange mechanics, which exchanges one token for the other. The operating one that we have designed to build is scalable. And we do this, as I'll explain, in a fully regulated framework. So regulation has been key to our strategy. The coronavirus is here and now, and is changing the face of the streets from one day to the next. What is necessary is a fully compliant strategy that can support the governments in its existing activities. The Swiss OTF license, as it's technically called, it's a broker and dealer license, which allows for an organized trading facility, can be used as a legal framework and platform for issuance of tokens from within Switzerland, but also from around the world. Securities brokers from any country can then access those tokens that have been issued on this platform. So the regulatory setup which we do is designed to be exportable into different countries. Thank you for watching this first video and looking forward to answering any of your questions. Enjoy the day. Thanks.